Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Historical Gamer once again, and today we're returning to Ultimate General Civil War. I'm currently streaming this live at like 3 in the morning. I had intended to stream about 4 hours ago, but I ended up falling asleep. And waking up and, you know, not being able to fall back asleep, I decided why not go ahead and stream. In this video, we're going to be streaming the Battle of Chancellorsville. It is one of the new battles in Ultimate General Civil War. The newest update added the Battle of Stone River, which is a fight in Tennessee. It's definitely a fight I'm going to cover, but I wanted to do a little bit of reading up on the battle because I don't know a ton about it. I know Rosecrans attacks Bragg and Bragg counterattacks, and it's somewhat of an indecisive battle, and one of the rarely talked about fights, one of the bloodiest fights in the Civil War. It was definitely in one of the top 10 bloodiest battles, and yet it very rarely gets covered. It had over 20,000 casualties over multiple days of fighting. But what we're actually going to be looking at is, I believe, the third or fourth largest battle in terms of casualties in the entire Civil War, and that is the Battle of Chancellorsville. It actually had the second single bloodiest day in the entire Civil War, May 3rd, 1863, just a few hundred or a few thousand behind the Battle of Antietam. More than 23,000 soldiers fell on May 3rd. The vast majority of the 30,000 plus casualties that occurred at Chancellorsville. Chancellorsville would be the bloodiest battle in the Civil War up to this point, until the Battle of Gettysburg, which occurred shortly thereafter. It's most well known for General Stonewall Jackson's flank attack on May 2nd of 1863, but the real turning point of the battle ended up being May 3rd, which again was the bloodiest of the fights. It's interesting that Jackson always gets this sort of heroic treatment for his flank assault on the Union Army, and while certainly surprising and devastating to the Union force, and it played a role in their eventual defeat, it was not the decisive action that it's often portrayed. The battle did not end there. It wasn't something where the Union skedaddled and were driven from the field and, you know, never were able to recover. The battle really was decided on May 3rd of 1863. So it'll be interesting to see how Ultimate General covers this fight. We're going to go ahead and fight it, and I think the only way to properly... Did I just close that? And I think the only way to properly fight the Battle of Chancellorsville is fighting from the Confederate side, at least from an initial impression, because that's, I don't know, maybe that's wrong, but I mean, holding out against forces one-third your size doesn't quite seem as exciting, right? Okay, so the fight will start on April 30th, 1863. This fight occurred after the Union disasters at Fredericksburg. If you remember, I played that battle on my channel previously, and the Union lost something like 60,000 men. After the disaster at Fredericksburg, Ambrose Burnside was replaced by Joseph Hooker, which certainly would have happened in our case. Hooker attempts to cross the Rappahannock River and engage Confederate Army of Northern Virginia with a more sophisticated plan than his predecessor. He divides his large army of 134,000 soldiers, 413 cannons, leaving a third of it to pin the Confederates defending the river passage at Fredericksburg. The cavalry is dispatched to raid deep inside Confederate territory, while the rest of his forces initiate a wide flanking maneuver to attack Lee's army from the west. Lee faces serious threat of double envelopment from east and west while being seriously outnumbered because Longstreet, who has a full half of his army, his corps is operating in the siege of Suffolk, Virginia. After the success at Fredericksburg, Lee detached Longstreet's force to head into, you know, the southern kind of coastal regions in an attempt to recover some of those territories that had been lost to Union forces operating from their navy and against southern ports in an attempt to, you know, blockade the Confederacy. Lee detached Longstreet's corps to head there. It also was used as a foraging campaign to attempt to, you know, gain some additional supplies from other parts of the Confederacy that had been less touched by war. As a result, Lee faces a serious threat, again, because he only has about a little bit more than half of his regular army, some 46,000 men. He had some 75,000 men at Fredericksburg. He only lost a handful of a couple thousand men there. So, you know, he was still well over 70,000 troops with almost 30,000 troops dispatched away from his front. Hooker's confident that Lee will finally be outmaneuvered and will withdraw toward Richmond, but Lee has other plans, obviously. So we got the 1st and the 2nd Corps. The 1st Corps directly under Lee, it appears, in this, given that the majority of it's away with Longstreet. So Union corps have crossed the western fords of the Rappahannock River and are now marching inside Confederate territory. Stuart, well, North of the Rappahannock was still inside Confederate territory, but anyway, Stuart's cavalry has detected enemy infantry marching down the U.S. Ford Road. More Union infantry is heading our way from Ely Ford. So the Rappahannock is just a river with a ton of fords around it, and these fords tend to be these defensive positions where the Confederates can delay or hinder the Union advance. And on the Orange Turnpike, it seems they're massing to attack our left. Their forces in Fredericksburg are only demonstrating an attack. It's a trap! Where's General Akbar? Okay. They're establishing a camp near Chancellor's Farm, and tomorrow they will be a serious threat. We must attack them before they concentrate all of their corps. That probably is ill-advised. Stop making entrenchments. Tomorrow we will attack and surprise Hooker. Okay. The Union 5th, 7th, and, oh my god, that's not 7th, is it 8th? And 2nd Corps are at Chancellorsville and are preparing to advance. Man, this is a sprawling battlefield. Two divisions of Meade's 5th Corps have been marching via the River Road, but they're not a threat. They will soon realize they're encircled and will run back like chickens. Okay. This is a lot to take in. There's a lot of, you know, this is going on here and this is going on here. And I wonder how much of it's relevant to the fight we're about to see. McLaws' division is now marching to secure the Orange Turnpike, which leads to the town of Fredericksburg. Okay. Anderson's division runs to secure the other road, which leads to Fredericksburg. Almost all our forces in Fredericksburg are dispatched to defend those roads and will soon join us. Only Early's division and Garnett's brigade are staying to defend. Let's hope the risk we take plays off. So basically, to summarize what all this kind of complicated goings-on is, the Confederates had been based out of Fredericksburg. The Union surprised them by moving north on the Rappahannock River, crossing the river, and essentially turning the Confederates out of their position at Fredericksburg. Lee races the bulk of his army back from Fredericksburg to deal with the threat that's now in his rear, which is more than 100,000 Union soldiers coming up into his rear, leaving a small force to pin the Union forces at Fredericksburg, which remain there. So the Union left some 30,000 men or so at Fredericksburg. So Lee couldn't completely abandon that, otherwise he'd be opening up his other rear. So he's got to cover his rear with the bulk of his forces while maintaining a small percentage of his force at Fredericksburg to deal with the potential threat of Union troops there. Okay, so that battle description was a little bit confusing in that I have no real idea. It looks like we've got to hold the Orange Plank Road and the Orange Turnpike. We also want to try and capture Chancellor's Farm. I love this game. I'm putting that out there, but I think that was a really hasty and poorly done explanation of what's going on. I think there was just too much back and forth and not really much clarity on, you know, who's doing what. Oops. But anyway. So we've got like three different pieces to the army here. We've got Stuart's cavalry on the flank. We've got, and can we actually run up here and capture Chancellor's Crossing? We'll at least scout that out with our cavalry to see what's over there. This is a huge battlefield compared to pretty much all the other battlefields. It'll be interesting because this is this first kind of massive epic battle that the game is really covering. In terms of Second Manassas, it wasn't that big. Antietam was, but it was on a very small, condensed field. So it'll be interesting to see how this battle plays out, which occurred over a much more sprawling field than, you know, for example, Antietam. Gettysburg was a similarly big battle, so this is kind of the first attempt to cover one of these gigantor battles. Can you download this game on a laptop? Yeah, I'm sure you can. And by the way, the most recent patch does add the ability to play this game on a Mac now. I think it depends. If they implement multiplayer, which I don't know if it has been fully confirmed, but if they implement multiplayer, yeah, it could be very complex. I think a lot of it depends on how they decide to do it. Okay, so Stuart sending his cavalry forward. What are they armed with, by the way? Lamats. Okay, so they're both armed with Lamats. Okay, so enemy artillery. Run away! Run away! Just trying to scout the enemy positions. Looks like they're in defensive positions here near Chancellor's Farm. Wonder if they have a flank. Oh! Artillery's everywhere! Get into the trees! I am not a historian. I'm just more of a history lover. I did write my senior thesis as an undergrad on some Civil War topics, but I'm not, you know, I don't have a master's or a PhD in history. But I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express once. Charge of the Light Brigade. Cannon to the left of him, cannon to the right of him. That was from the Charge of the Light Brigade, right? Okay, so what's our objective here? Victory, hold the orange turnpike, plank road, and Chancellor's Farm. Although this is for the whole battle, so Union secure. Ah, shit. Them Federals took the road. Bastards. Wow, I didn't even notice there's a fence line here. So apparently there's a lot of defensive terrain around here. Let's go pin these guys and then maybe we can run these guys up into their, well, I don't know, that's a big brigade. It's kind of an open field too. The interesting thing is with Chancellorsville, like, it's this sprawling group of forests and whatnot that you've got to kind of deal with, but on the flip side there's the battle really was intensely fought in a small series of open areas that, all right, you're going to go here. Federals to our left. Get into cover. Ugh. There's a lot of them. Jesus Christ, they're behind us. Get out of there, Mahone. You got troops literally right behind you. Or just kind of sit there with troops to your rear. Run the fuck away. Or no, just turn and face them, I guess. I don't know. Stupid trees. I don't know why the enemy is not taking position in these woods. That would make more sense, I think. All right. Some of these defensive terrain positions don't make sense. Like a fence line right in front of a forest. Your back is to where you'd be vulnerable. Your front is forward against an area that doesn't really do you any good. Well, you got another brigade coming in. Like, you'd want to be facing the fence line this way, not north. That's weird. And then this long fence line that's kind of perpendicular to, I don't know. Seems odd. These make more sense. So we can bring a brigade up Ross's flank. Maybe we'll advance to this wood line. Posey will advance into this fence line now because he's got Burbank coming, but now he can get along this fence line and Burbank's in an open field and Posey will not be. And Mahone's retreating. Great. Robert E. Lee commanding. Rhodes division's here. Quickly send them to repel the Federals. Is that Rhodes Division up here? Looks like it. Oh my goodness. I don't even know. This is an interesting fight, I will say that. No. Okay. So Mahone can kind of rally. We're going to send Lee up here. Hopefully Lee doesn't get killed. And then we're going to send Seems behind the Union troops here. Mahone, you just got to hang out. Oh my God, you're taking huge casualties. Just hang on for a little bit here. We're going to run Sims into the rear of the enemy. Should cause him to pull back. And the Federals rout. There we go. No. I just want you to shoot. I don't want you to melee him. Come on, shoot at him. That was dumb. Oh, wait. There's a brigade to her rear. Like, what the hell? This is kind of a clusterfuck. All right. Where are we sending these guys? No. We're going to send you guys over here to prepare for an attack on Chancellor's Crossing. We'll send some artillery support up there. Jackson, you'll move this way. This is really a sideshow fight at the end of the day. Colson's division's entering the attack. We outnumber them. Attack! Okay. Good Lord. We've got a lot of troops all just kind of marching through the forest. So we'll go ahead and move these guys over here. A.B. Hill's division's arrived now. Okay. So the entire Confederate Army is showing up on the field. All right. The problem is getting these guys all into position, right? Because of these damn forests. Like, there needs to be a road command or something. Can we take this supply? Are there enemy troops here? I know it's kind of wooded and not the best terrain. Oh, shit. No. Mahone, you stay there. That's what I wanted. Okay. Pull back. Cavalry took some supplies. That's fine. We just took some supplies from the enemy rear. Send these guys over here. All right. Yeah, the problem is generally when I try and talk history while playing things. Oh my God, that was a mistake. I didn't want you to charge. Usually when I describe historical events while playing, I screw up like that. Although Lee's charged. Oh, there's another brigade over there. Would have said it did really well up until the point where that other enemy brigade volleyed us. I guess I forgot that Lamats are really good. They're sabers and revolvers, but... Okay. Retreat out of there, Lee. You butchered that enemy brigade, but you lost half your regiment as well. Okay. Waiting for my troops to come up. Right, now what? We're winning! We outnumber them. Push them back, General. It's advised not to advance too much near the camp because more of them will soon arrive. Okay, well, I'm already pushing them back, so that's good, I suppose. I guess we'll bring Kershaw up. Well, we'll bring some artillery up to the camp. These guys, move them this way. There's definitely troops in these woods. That's the difficult thing is, how much do you want to go into those woods? Meanwhile, there's a brigade to our rear here, so we can only push so hard there. Kind of curious what the design decision is on all of these defensive positions. I don't know if the Yankees are going to attack us or what's the end game there. Meanwhile, our other troops are all still taking their damn sweet time. Oh no, they're here. Never mind. I thought I told these guys to move further up. Did it cancel my orders as soon as that last update came in? This is a gigantic battle. I should actually, it might make more sense to use the organizational commands rather than just dragging and dropping. All right. See, like, great, you've got your backs to a fence. Anything that might make you bigger targets. See, this is a. I'm not. I'm probably gonna get embarrassed here. I'm not very good at. Like, oh, attack along this way, but you're actually attacking with enemy troops all over all of your flanks. Fortunately, some of our units have pretty good cover. Perry's got good cover here. Actually, probably better than what the enemy has. So we got three brigades engaged here. All these other troops are coming up. We'll go ahead and send these guys up as well. Lee, you'll come over here. And you can see here, actually, our cavalry over here is getting butchered, just standing there taking fire from the enemy. You could be a little bit smarter than that, Cav. Okay. I'm sure people are gonna lambast me eventually when I post this video, like, oh my goodness, look at all these troops he's not using. Let's see. Winslow's giving about as good as he's taking. Perry's just taking casualties. Why don't you go engage? Ramaseur, come up. Mahone, come up. Iverson, come up. We've got to use these wood lines, though. Sims, I wonder if you can get into these woods on the flank. There might be some cover there. Wright would probably have to leave these woods. It's true, I could pause the game, but, and maybe I should, but I haven't. Obviously. Are they still in cover? Eh, they've still got some cover. Probably not much more than... A general couldn't pause a battle while they're fighting it, right? So why should I? I realize it's a game. That's probably not the best analogy to use, but... Let's see here. Woodford... Okay. All right. They're pulling out. There you go. These troops are still coming up. I'm gonna try and avoid directly attacking into these woods. I'm more or less gonna just demonstrate against them. Heath might come down on their flank, I'm not sure. We'll see if we can get him over there. I don't know what they have in those, you know, over there in those woods. And McGovern will go ahead and support Wolford. But I'd like to avoid, you know, marching. Doing exactly what I'm doing with Wilcox and marching across the open against entrenched enemy troops. Why aren't these guys... Oh! Whoa. I've still got a ton of guys I'm not using. Just select them all and... Oh my god, this is a huge... This is going to be a very difficult battle, I think, to manage. Like, if you think about Gettysburg or anything like that, and this is just day one of Chancellorsville, this is a minor engagement. Why are you doing that? Halt. Engage. Don't just, like, march up in column formation. The computer AI needs to be better in this game. I also feel like you need better AI on your own team. Like, I get it. It's your army, but... It would be much more interesting to me if, you know, you had some semblance of intelligent sub-commanders. Because a battle like this gets really unmanageable really quick. All right, Lee, get out of there. You can't really control if they're in double lines or anything like that. It's just manual. Heath coming down their rear. It looks like they've got troops that are guarding their flank, so that won't do much good. I don't know what the best way to attack him is. Maybe swinging wide left? Bring our cavalry over here. By the way, this is probably a lesson in how not to general, if we're being honest. Okay, there we go. We push them out of their positions. Charge in from the rear. Ross is doomed. Darius N. Couch. Right over here, the federal commander. Well, I feel like I did a decent job of managing that flank attack. Now get my horses out of there before they get butchered. Just destroyed that enemy brigade. Okay. Oh, look at that. Enemy troops to our rear. Stupid brigade that was in behind us. Outnumbered 3-1. Charge cavalry into him. I'm just trying to really destroy this brigade. That's my goal. Destroy Knap. Holy crap. Look at that number fly downward. There you go. Good job, cavalry. Despite the massive casualties you've taken, you've inflicted more than you've taken. Okay, engage these guys. I don't think we're going to take Chancellor's Crossing. These men are too well dug in. Howard's 11th Corps is also coming to defend Chancellorsville. We cannot advance further. Okay. So Howard's coming up now. So I think we kind of did what we needed to do. We took the two roads. We couldn't take Chancellor's Crossing, but I think that's fine because I feel like this is where Hooker's headquarters was historically. And I don't want to destroy my army trying to attack these guys. I've already lost probably more men than I should. There's only a few minutes left. I know that was a bungled and mismanaged attack. But we've got quite a few troops I didn't engage. And again, I think that's okay in a battle like this where it's... Whoa, where are you going? Probably fire into these guys' flank. Although exposing your own. And all these troops coming up on our flank. Refusing our left. Von Gliese. Don't worry, guys. I'll embarrass you on May 2nd. Howard's Corps, the 11th Corps that took the brunt of the flanking assault on May 2nd. Proceeding to the next day. Alright, guys. I hope that wasn't too painful. Again, what I'm going to be doing, and I didn't mention it at the start because I thought the intro of the stream was pretty good, but what I'm going to be doing with this series or this stream is I'm going to play a couple episodes of Chancellorsville, play through that battle. I'll do Stones River as well, but I'm working on a new campaign is the Union, which I may come back to these battles also. That Union campaign will be far more focused on historical discussion and historical events, whereas this was more of a ad hoc live stream. I'm not as good at kind of introing and describing things in these kind of videos. I hope you did enjoy it nonetheless. This is kind of a first look at the Battle of Chancellorsville in Ultimate General, hope you guys continue to tune in. Let me know your thoughts below, and until next time, part 2 will be Jackson's flank assault. But in the meantime, hope you guys enjoyed, and have a nice day.